Thank you, Annick. So first we listened to the people from DLR summarizing their study, which was really interesting. So they researched the climate impact of a major modal shift to light electric vehicles from public cars. And I think there were a few headlines, so a few numbers that we should keep in mind also after leaving this session. First, that is that over 3 out of 4 car trips can be substituted by light electric vehicle trips. And this will lead to 50% of car kilometers that can be substituted in total. And in these trips, it's important that 80% of the greenhouse gases can be saved. So this is quite huge. And besides this, of course, there's also other benefits that we didn't really zoom in on, but we will have less congestion, more room for public spaces, and so on. And there was also a call for action to achieve to achieve this full potential, such as removal of legal bottlenecks in infrastructure and push and pull incentives. Afterwards, we had the interesting discussion with the panels here and online about the science and the future about this. And I tried to get some global ideas that were discussed, because several ideas were rent on the table, but I'll try to summarize it. I think there were a few common thoughts. First of all, I think everybody was happy that it's good that some research has been carried out about the wide variety of light electric vehicles. And also a common conclusion that it's good to compare light electric vehicles with smartphones, because that gives us quite an example and where we can end up in the future. Also, some challenges, I think, were defined. The overall challenge, of course, was how can we move people to these light electric vehicles? And then few ideas were put on the table, such as let's make the infrastructure at a human scale. I think in Europe, for example, the guy from Brussels that was presenting it this morning, we're already taking some steps, but then Mr. Cherry said that in some cities of the USA, there is some work on the table. Also, there is some benefits we can take in connecting light electric vehicles with public transport, and there are gains we still can get in vehicle technology. Let's have reliable and comfortable vehicles that are comparable with the comfort and reliability of a car. Also, a good idea, I think, would be, that I heard, was to have research on the incentive infrastructure. Lots of money is going to incentivizing electric cars, but let's measure. What's the effect of 1 euro that goes to incentivizing electric cars? And what's the real impact of 1 euro that's going to incentivizing light electric vehicles? Another out-of-the-box ideas was let's promote light electric vehicles, not as vehicles, but as gadgets, because people like gadgets. And also science will make a profit out of this, because scientists like data, and they will have more data to play with. And let's have light electric vehicle zones instead of low emission zones, so LEV zones instead of LE zones. And then as a last one, think global and look at countries that we might oversee, because we're looking at the European context. But in some countries, like India, like China, things are happening, and we can learn from this. So that was what I picked up for the discussion with the panel. And then I think, again, I would like to conclude with what the person from the European Commission said this morning. He started his part in the panel with saying, yes, this is true. The future is electric, and the future is light.
Thank you very much, Bram. So we have now come to the point where we will conclude the event. But before doing that, I would like to say briefly a few words about the rest of our plans. So obviously, we are extremely thrilled with the DLR findings. And for LEVA-EU, this DLR report is only a first step in a long-term journey. From here onwards, we will be doing 2 major things. First of all, we will now systematically go and meet decision makers at all levels to ask for their due attention to LEVs, to achieve increased uptake and use of LEVs. To substitute the use of large heavy vehicles, the EU must identify and remove legal bottlenecks hampering technological and market development of LEVs without any further delay. Furthermore, in policies developed at all levels of government, LEVs should be dealt with as a separate vehicle category, which requires its own specific rules. Now, our political plea will be much stronger because it can rely on hard numbers in a scientific report. Secondly, we want to further, sorry, we want to further encourage research into light electric vehicles, as well as networking among LEV researchers. And our plans to achieve this have not yet fully taken shape, but in the next weeks and months, we will continue to work on them. Nevertheless, we have made a start on setting up a LEV researchers community. We are very happy that we have the first researchers to endorse the manifesto, and we will definitely in the next few weeks and months continue to engage with other researchers to also endorse the manifesto. Furthermore, we have created a new website called Go Electric and Light as a base for our research community. We will actively address researchers all over to follow the example of their colleagues, as I said, by joining the manifesto. But also, we are in the process of creating a library of LEV research on our website. As said, this is a work in progress, and we are looking forward to consult with LEV researchers on how to further develop all this. Another part of the website will be dedicated to the LEV community, a part specifically aimed at exchanging best practice and inspiring and encouraging individuals, organizations, companies, and public authorities to significantly reduce the weight and thus the carbon footprint of their electric trips. We are therefore inviting all these parties to make a pledge about their intentions to increase the uptake and use of light electric vehicles. Before closing this event, I would like to explicitly thank the DLR research team, especially Masha, Simone and Laura, for their professionalism, their open-mindedness, for being meticulous and patient. Also, thanks to Brendan Hill, our moderator today, for his enthusiastic support for the project. Forum Europe, Roberta Bonomotti, and the whole LEVA-EU team for their hard work, which has made this event a success. Finally, I would like to thank you, the public, your enthusiastic participation in and contribution to our event, The Future is Electric and Light, has been very inspiring and encouraging. And it shows that in Europe, there is already a lot of enthusiasm for light electric vehicles. We hope that with the insights gained today, that enthusiasm will grow bigger and deeper. Let me finish with a graph from the International Council on Clean Transportation, an American independent NGO providing technical and scientific analysis to environmental regulators. The DLR report has made me confident that if they would include light electric vehicles in their projections, this graph would look much more positive, with the possibility to even potentially still reach the 1.5 degree compatible pathways. Thank you very much and have a nice day.